Good evening, I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Brandi Peterson. We begin with late breaking details on what allegedly happened the morning Tyler Thomas disappeared.
Keitel told investigators that early Friday morning he spotted Thomas walking toward her dorm, picked her up in his car. The two then drove to a place outside of Peru. That's where they had sexual contact. But Keitel told investigators it ended with a physical and verbal confrontation. And Keitel said Thomas threatened to tell everyone he had raped her.
Now, the court records don't explain what happened next or what may have happened to Tyler Thomas after that. Keitel told investigators he drove back to campus and took a shower to wash off any physical evidence that would connect him to Thomas.
He started out with one story and changed it. You have to use some caution because you want to make sure you don't disclose any parts of the ongoing investigation that could impair that investigation. So you do have to exercise caution in that respect.
And then our interview with the Nemaha County Attorney this afternoon. Again, at this point, Keitel is only considered a person of interest.
He is facing charges of tampering with evidence and withholding information.
Our big story at 6 continues with KETV News Watch 7's Natalie Glucklich live in Peru.
Brandi, the Nemaha County Attorney's Office tells us investigators have been narrowing their search for Thomas, eliminating certain areas around town. But with rough terrain, fields and streams and rivers, they say it has been quite a task. Meanwhile, here on Peru campus, there are students telling us they are praying for Thomas's safe return, and they are disturbed that this break in the case means that one of their own is behind bars. They're tying a tie for tie, and with each ribbon that blows in the wind, students here at Peru State College are hoping a message will somehow reach their friend, Tyler Thomas.
Well, next week is finals week, and we're all going home. We are remembering, and we do have this to remember, and we're not leaving her behind.
The tree for Ty takes life on a day police make a break in the case that inspired it. Wednesday, officers arrest 29-year-old Peru State student Joshua Keitel on charges he tampered with evidence and withheld information in connection with Thomas's disappearance. Officials aren't detailing exactly what that is, but he's now being called a person of interest in the case, and the college suspended him.
I think everybody's still a little bit in shell shock mode.
Aaron Dietz and Tony Trainer know Keitel.
A lot of kids go to the gym at night and play basketball and stuff.
They say he sometimes cracks jokes in class, but mostly keeps to himself.
I'm not really sure what to think at this point. A little bit double-sided. I mean, we're glad that there's a lead going into it, but at the same time, you know, when they arrest somebody as a person of interest, you get the thoughts that, you know, there's some bad stuff going on with Ty still.
Thomas was last seen here on campus early Friday morning, and even though she hasn't been seen since, her friends hope she'll return to see this.
Just have this tree like covered in ties and in ornaments and envelopes, and just so, you know, when she does come home, she can see all the love and support from Peru students and her Peru family.
Students here at Peru State College tell me Keitel played football at Wayne State before transferring here last year. We also learned he was facing a criminal mischief charge, or he was in court last week facing that criminal mischief charge. On October 29th, Keitel allegedly broke a dorm room door here on campus. He has yet to enter a plea. He has another hearing set for January. Rob and Brandi, back to you.
Natalie Glucklich reporting live. Thanks, Natalie.